How important is it to have a beard?
That was not decided by me. All men grow beard. Some men remote.
Exactly.
Only one remote here. We should ask him why he remote. Does he have a good reason? Ignorance is a consequence that has come because most human beings ignore everything around them. Loneliness has become one of the biggest problems in the world. Most people think other people die. It's one thing everybody must do before they go to bed. For a few minutes, if they see their bed as their deathbed, just see that next 1 minute you're going to die. If there was no belief in the world, if there was no religion in the world, a whole lot of people probably would not know how to manage themselves. I would say it's a very inexpensive psychiatry.
If you believe in something, that's not the solution. What's the solution?
In one part of the world, what they believe looks ridiculous to people in another part of the world. Happiness is an emotion, misery is an emotion, joy is an emotion, suffering is an emotion, agony, ecstasy, everything is different levels of emotion, pleasantness or unpleasantness.
That everything that doesn't kill us make us stronger, isn't that also the truth?
See, if you want to live by slogans, it's fine. Let's explore something.
Well, you have it for you yourself. Welcome to the show, Sadhguru.
Thank you.
I wonder about the title guru. Is that a protected title, or could anyone become a guru?
Sadhguru is not a title, it's a description. That is, if you want to have your eyes checked up, you don't go to your gynecologist.
I see, yes.
You know where to go.
Sounds, yeah.
So when you say a Sadhguru, it essentially means an uneducated guru. That means if you want to know scriptures, you don't go to him. If you want to know religion, you don't go to him. If you want to read your future, you don't go to him. There's only one thing he knows. He knows this piece of life from its origin to its ultimate, absolutely. He knows nothing else.
How important is it to have a beard?
That was not decided by me. All men grow beard. Some men remote.
Exactly.
Only one remote here. We should ask him why he remote. Does he have a good reason?
Is that?
We're teaming up here, huh?
I see. I regret the question. You know, it doesn't make him a guru.
That's his choice. So at a very early age, I tried to enhance my vision, enhance my hearing, trying to see and hear things which others do not hear normally and see. Essentially, what I realized was ignorance is a consequence that has come because most human beings ignore everything around them. It's a consequence of that. So I paid attention and paid attention.
So here now, what are you paying attention to? What can you sense that I can't?
See, this is, people are always thinking paying attention means something magical should be happening. Mm. But the most magical things are happening right now. We are sitting on a tiny mud ball called Earth. It's spinning in the middle of nowhere. Nowhere knows where this creation begins, where it ends. Here we are, sitting and talking like this. Isn't this a magical thing? And I'm paying attention. Even though I'm a microscopic speck in this universe, still I have an individual experience. I can see this as me and see this as her, see this as somebody else. This speck should be nothing actually, but this speck of a thing has individual experience, a sense of individuality, which is such a tremendous thing. I think most people don't appreciate that, they always suffer that. And loneliness has become one of the biggest problems in the world because they do not appreciate their individual nature.
So would you say that we are too easily bored in our own company?
If you're bored when you're alone, obviously you're in bad company.
The fact that we are, as a species, are aware, and perhaps more aware than the animals, of our time as limited. We know that we're gonna get old. We know that we're gonna die someday.
Really, most people think other people die.
But not ourselves.
Yes, most people think other people die. They don't understand. For every one of us, time is ticking away right now as we sit here. What is ticking away is not the clock. What is ticking away is our life as we sit here. If we know this, we would have no time for doing any nonsense with ourselves. We would do what means absolutely most to us, not silly things. One thing everybody must do before they go to bed, for a few minutes, if they see their bed as their deathbed, just see that next 1 minute you're going to die. In these last 24 hours, have you lived this 24 hours the way you want it if this is the last moment? Every day if they do it, they will come to their senses, you know.
Some people find comfort in religion. How about you?
One must look at this, that the real thing is that you don't know where you came from and you don't know where you go. You can believe what you want. If there was no belief in the world, if there was no religion in the world, a whole lot of people probably would not know how to manage themselves. I would say it's a very inexpensive psychiatry. It's not a solution, but for that moment it settles them, which I feel is important, it does a certain part of the job. But those who are seeking to know life, to know the very nature of their existence, then belief is of no use, because belief means you're assuming something that you do not know. Seeking truth means you're unwilling to assume anything that you do not know.
What are you thinking now?
I was just thinking, you say that to believe it's not a solution, but what's the solution? If that is… do you understand what I mean? You're telling us that if you believe in something, that's not the solution. What's the solution?
See, you know that in different parts of the world, people believe different things. Mm. In one part of the world, what they believe looks ridiculous to people in another part of the world. So belief is a consequence of social influence. It has no existential significance. Only what you perceive genuinely, that's all you know. Rest is all your imagination.
But how do you actually sharpen your observations or your perception?
This mechanism, the human mechanism, is the most sophisticated mechanism on the planet. Everything that ever happened to you, pain and pleasure, joy and misery, agony and ecstasy, even light and darkness, is only happening within you. Physical pain is a natural phenomenon. Mental pain is something that you do to yourself, because the way you think and the way you feel is entirely your choice.
But what about mourning? So you think you
can turn your feelings off, mental, if you're hurting?
Why should you turn it off?
I would say that you choose to feel sad or… but you don't choose it. I mean, if…
Yes.
Is there a magic…
No.
Turn off…
Someone
turn
like my son died, I have… it's not my decision. So I'm… I don't know how to move around that pain and not…
You are in a some way. Just now I heard both of you saying, it was translated to me, you were saying that when you think of him, you're more joyful thinking of all the wonderful things, and that's how it should be. Because a life that came into your life and exited for whatever reasons, you respect that. A life comes and goes, it's not our making. You cherish that life for what it's been for you. See, the only reason why you value it is it, in some way it's been beautiful, all right? Should you cherish it or should you grieve it?
But
well,
still…
this is not a philosophy, let me come to that. But right now, whether there is joy or pain or misery or ecstasy or blissfulness, all are emotions, isn't it? happiness is an emotion, misery is an emotion, joy is an emotion, suffering is an emotion, agony, ecstasy, everything is different levels of emotion, pleasantness or unpleasantness. Now I am asking you a simple question, please listen to this carefully. If you had a choice between being pleasant or unpleasant within yourself, what is your choice?
I take pleasant.
That's it. So, this guy is straight. You're all thinking, because you're thinking there is something to it. No, it's as straight as this.
It's said that everything that doesn't kill us make us stronger. Isn't that also the truth?
See, if you want to live by slogans, it's fine. Let's explore something.
Well, you have it for you yourself.
But for the pleasantness of your body, for the pleasantness of your mind, emotion and energy, it is 100% your business. If you have excuses, unfortunate. There are no excuses. It's just that you're choosing to be that way.
Are you always pleasant?
Within myself, absolutely. The question is not about do you always pleasant, unpleasant. What happens within me, something else cannot determine that, that's all.
Sadhguru, where do you believe your father is now, his soul is now? Do you believe in an afterlife, or is death sort of a line?
Is it true that you slowly gathered this body over a period of time? So, this is just a piece of earth that you gathered. If so much if you have to gather, something more fundamental must be there, isn't it?
Sadhguru, it's been wonderful to talk to you. Thank you so much.